guys, this is my first ever Let's Play, and I'm going to be playing Golden Corn, The Road to El Dorado. This is a game that I actually played as a kid, but I only finished it once, and after that my CD broke, so I haven't actually been able to play it since. And as a kid who barely understood any English at the time, it was really hard to actually play it. And I know the quality is a bit bad, but this is the only copy that I could find for the emulator.
El Dorado. Yes, El Dorado. What an adventure. What a story. Who would believe it? Who could possibly tell it? Tulio, you are the hero. You must tell it.
No, Miguel, please. You are the hero. You must tell it.
Yes, I will. But, where do I start?
We were in Spain.
Yes.
In the marketplace.
Yes.
It was morning.
No, it was evening.
It was morning. We had just woke
from our siesta. It was evening.
Am I telling the story?
You're the hero.
Compromise.
That's a deal.
It was midday in the marketplace in Spain.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of graphic errors, but nothing I can do about that. And, I actually find the game a lot more funny than the movie was. There's a lot of humor in the game, so it's great that the voice acting is good.
Julio, that's us!
Oh, no.
It's nice to be wanted, isn't it?
This isn't hugs and kisses wanted, Miguel. This is thrown into a stinking cell and forgotten about wanted.
Oh.
We'd better get out of town and quick. And we better keep away from the town guard, too. This poster worries me, Miguel.
Certainly brings out your worst features.
You're a true friend. Anybody watching?
No.
Yeah, the controls are a bit awkward, and it doesn't help that I'm playing on a keyboard. I'll probably do some weird running arounds at some point.
Greetings.
Because of my R2 binding.
Golden bounty of the new world.
Could you give me a small bag of corn?
If you want to set him, I shall.
One peseta? That's all the money we have in the world.
The world.
Here you go, one peseta.
Here you go, one small bag of corn.
Now let's go get that chicky.
Look, Miguel, a chicken!
It doesn't seem to belong to anybody.
Okay, this is a wild runaway chicken. Ooh, scary.
I love how they've given subtitles for the chicken voices.
Here, chicky. Yum, lovely corn. Say goodbye to freedom, bird.
It's just hilarious.
It's eaten all our corn.
Who cares? We're one chicken up on the deal.
Someone might be wondering why I would choose this game as the first game to do as a Let's Play. And I admit it's a slightly silly choice, but there's the fact that there's really no full playthrough of the game on YouTube at all, and it's
really
not in English at all.
What do you sell?
Chicken.
Maybe a couple of videos only.
Oh? How much for a chicken?
20%.
Very reasonable. What will you give me for this splendid free-range chicken?
5%.
What? But you sell them for 20.
That's how the market works, mister. Buy low, sell high.
This is an outrage.
Haven't I seen your face before?
5 pesetas, eh? We'll take it.
Now comes the most annoying part in the game, basically. Well, most tedious at least. A gambling game! Like, basically you can win it on the first try, or you'll be here for 3 hours. About the graphics glitch.
I'm in.
Excellent. How much can you wager?
5 pesetas.
Ah, now you're talking. Show me the money and we can play.
Okay, we've got enough money to get into your dice game. Let's play!
Such enthusiasm. The dice awaits, gentlemen. The rules are simple. The first player rolls two dice. The second player decides whether he will roll higher or lower and chooses how much to risk on his guess. No more than 4%, though. The first player matches the bet and then the dice are rolled.
Well, what if the second player rolls the same as the first?
Then the first player wins. But don't worry, we take turns at being first.
Okay, here we go.
I say higher. I'll
well, obviously higher.
1%.
I'll match that.
My luck is usually crap at these. Just nothing doing it. Oh boy.
I win. Very well. Your turn.
Now I'll get a super crappy one.
Next. Do you want to bet your roll higher or
lower? Let's go
higher.
Higher.
How much would you like to wager, my friend?
I'll wager...
2.
Who, Pesetas?
I'll match your stake.
Wow, I actually got it over higher by 1.
I win! Yes!
Now my turn.
I need to make it so that when the betting goes, he doesn't have enough money.
I'll wager 1%.
I'll match that.
Now he needs to lose.
A 5. You win.
Yay.
Very well. Your turn.
Now I can just put a bet that he can do since he only has 1 peseta left. Let's go lower.
Lower! I'll wager...
Let's just... put 3.
3 pesetas!
I have no more money.
Then we'll be on our way. It's been delightful doing business.
Wait, one more wager.
But you're cleaned out, man.
Not
cleaned
money.
Out?
There's something far more precious.
Gems?
No. This map.
You can keep your map.
Imagine my excitement. A map. Work on. Have a map.
A map of what?
Tulio has the right idea.
Showing the secret road.
Then again, this would be a really short game otherwise if we could just leave now.
El Dorado, the city of fairy tale, you mean?
It doesn't exist, Miguel. It's just a trick to pull.
El Dorado.
Oh, bro.
The wager is simple. If I win, I'm back in the game. If you win, you get the map.
And the money.
No. I keep the money.
What a bastard.
The map's worth a million times more than these few.
We agree. Are you crazy?
Crazy?
Julio, it's the real thing. I know it.
Of course, if you doubt yourself.
Yeah, we need to trust Miguel's woman's intuition.
Then prove it.
I will.
You'd better be right about that map, Miguel.
Please, let it be under 10, please. Oh, it's 10.
A 10?
Phew, I forgot that I used to want to win.
Maybe, but we're not getting any money out of this.
Who cares about the money, Tulio? We've got the map to El Dorado. Well, I'm just quivering with excitement about that.
Just wait until we're at the fabled City of Gold.
Yeah, fabled has non-existent. Come on, let's go.
Alright, I'll conclude this as the first part of the Let's Play. See you.